What's up, y'all? This is Hussein Nasser from iGeometry, where we discuss software engineering by example. And this is our software talk series, where we pick a topic and casually talk about it, right? Today's topic is troubleshooting, right? Before we jump to the video, if you're new to this channel, consider subscribing. We have a lot of software engineering topics here. I have a lot of series. We have this series, the software talk. We just casually sit down and talk about things in software engineering, things that particularly interest me. We pick advanced stuff and we talk about it as well, illustrated by example. That's why it's software by example. We also have tutorials, JavaScript tutorials, C Sharp tutorials, GIS, that's my major. Basically, that's my specialty, geographic information system tutorials, a lot of tutorials, reverse engineering stuff. I love this series where we basically pick an app, a mainstream app, and try to reverse engineer it and see that how the developers actually designed that thing from scratch, all right? So what we need to do is get started with the troubleshooting. So if you're a software engineer, right, or even a developer, you run into problems essentially, right, with the software, like say a bug, right? There's, you click a button and software crash, right? Or that's my favorite, where you click a button to submit something and it takes a long time, right, just to perform that task, right? So that's you're down to the app itself. Let's say it's a mobile app or a web app or anything really, right? Troubleshooting can happen across the whole stack. So let's just discuss what's going on there. So troubleshooting, in my opinion, it's an art in itself. And depending on the personality, yes, the personality of the tester or the software engineer, you can tell how far down the rabbit hole a good software engineer can go to identify a problem. And that what makes him or her special or a good software engineer is by their troubleshooting skills. So what do I mean by that? So usually when you are a software engineer, you work with a developer, right? So says, okay, there's a developer that developed this piece and you found some performance problem with his work in that area. And you want to show him what exactly is wrong, right? So that's first of all, you found it, right? That's the first step. You find a bug or a problem. And you get a point by that, okay? You're good, that's your job. Your job is to find problems. As a software engineer, testers, you find problems, that's what you get paid for. That's the most of the thing. You just try to find problems with the software, okay? And then second thing is there are people that stops at step one, find the problem and send it to the developer. There are software engineers that do that. Hey, this thing doesn't work. Send an email. Hey, this thing is slow. Some people will say, yeah, I just did my job, right? Sure, you did your job. You did the bare minimum. You found it, kudos, right? But you didn't do the extra step. What's the extra step? Steps. If it's, let's say it's actually a mobile app, right? So it's gonna make it harder. So a mobile app. So how can you go deeper than that? Okay. It's like, where, how do you, what do you do after that? Okay. You click a button, right? Let's say this is like, I don't know, click and then it's slow, right? You can send it to the developer, says, hey, guys, this is not working, this is slow, right? Or you can do a little bit of due diligence and just ask yourself, what exactly going on there, right? Turn off for example, airplane mode, and then run the button again. Does the failure come quick or not? So why do you ask that? Because if it failed immediately, that means there is nothing wrong with the user experience, right? If it's still slow while the airplane mode is on, like there's no internet, there's nothing goes out the phone to make a request out there, then something wrong with the app itself, right? Something is spinning here before even sending that request to the server. So we can't just blame the server is slow yet, or the REST endpoint is slow. We have to just think about it a little bit, right? So that could be it. Another thing is you start sniffing the request after that goes out of the phone, okay? It's like turn it back on and click. Does the request comes up immediately after you click? Or just the phone starts thinking and do something and then the request comes? Depends, right? Each thing, anything means, any behavior will mean something, and you can make decisions based on that, okay? Some people will stop at that, say, hey, looks like an app problem, and that's good, that's perfect, okay? Some people say, you know what, I turned the Wi-Fi off or what, internet off, and then I still see it is slow, right? Or I still say, like, if for example, it failed immediately, right? So that means, okay, that the phone actually made the request, the app and the phone made the request, but, right, immediately failed because there are no internet connection or timed out immediately. So you sniff that request and you see now the request coming out, right? You start measuring that REST endpoint. So it says, so what you do instead, you remove the phone completely and you call the REST endpoint yourself, right? We're using the same parameters and see, okay, I'm gonna call this endpoint and see, simulate that request and see how long it takes. And it says, for example, took 5 seconds to reply. A lot, right? Or 100 or 2 seconds or 3 seconds, right? And that's time. Is it, now let's ask you a question, where is that time spent? Is that, is my network, does my network have problems? Is my server okay, right? Let's try that. Let's say, for example, is my request getting queued for some reason and then it didn't actually is being starved because it wasn't even served to begin with? Or is it actually being served and executed, but the REST input, the actual code behind the server, the middleware, is doing something, right? So you start diving deep into that, and then you start saying, okay, this button, for example, updates the profile page, right? Are we updating just the picture? Right? How big is the picture you're sending? Is it BMP? Is it bitmap? Is it just how big is it? How are we compressing it? So you see where I'm going with that, guys, right? So you can go up to the deepest level on the server and you can start asking yourself questions, and that would like go back to the database and start asking a little more questions about, okay, I took it down until the insert comes back, and then when the query is actually trying to select something, and that select statement is taking 3 seconds to, for example, to complete. So it's, whoa, okay, so you can take it all the way from your app, from your thin app, all the way to the database. You can start asking questions, okay, are we missing an index? Are we doing a full table scan? And you're asking all these questions, and that, just that spectrum of things will make you by default a better engineer, because you start questioning things, you start being just empathetic about the process, the whole thing. You have to put yourself in other people's shoes. You can't just throw stuff on the wall and just assume people will fix it, right? it might get you a job, but if you wanna advance in your career, be a better one, just doing that, you don't have to say anything. If you do that, right, people will notice. This is, oh shit, this guy's good. Because, well, instead of he gave me just, for example, just a problem, you have a problem, versus, hey, by the way, I think it's that table, we're doing a full table scan on it. So if we change the execution plan, we might actually have a better luck. Or if we analyze the table after adding this much data, or if we added an index, whatever the solution, right? Or for example, if it's just a REST API, we need to increase the queue size, or we need to add more servers, whatever the reason is. Just by giving that solution to the developer, or not even a solution, just tell them that, okay, I think this is where the problem is going on. Or for example, the developer is doing a bad thing, maybe instead of doing a select statement, right? They're doing a loop with a select, right? So, you know, code, you know, and bugs can happen. But you have to start analyzing and doing logging and learn all these skills to be a better software engineer. All right, guys, sorry, I always talk a lot in this series. That's what's called software talk. But hope you enjoyed this episode. Subscribe and like this video if you like it. And I'm going to see you in the next one. Check out the other content in this channel. There are a lot of good stuff. I think you're going to like it.